Morning. It's a blessed morning indeed. Surrounded by wonderful trees and animals, sounds of the birds, they're singing their morning song, full of life. And I know a lot of us are waking up going, oh, I have to wake up, my eyes hurt, I'm tired, I have to get up, I have to walk the dogs, all that kind of stuff. And then we have to go sit in traffic, a lot of us, so we're sitting in a room with no windows on your computer in a suit that's very uncomfortable or high heels, and that's not life, is it? And in doing all of this, we are accumulating money to pay bills, and should we have a little bit of extra money, we decide to spend it on things that we think we need or that we've been sold, basically, through internet marketing and TV commercials. And what that does to us is it makes us feel like we are not whole, that we have some sort of lack or need for things, instead of really being comfortable with just who we are and with what we have by living simply and breathing in the fresh air and just going, the fuck do I have to do today? Nothing. I don't have to do anything today. I don't. You don't. You don't have to stress over everything. You don't have to put your attention towards things that don't need your attention. Does that make sense? So take a deep breath with me now. In and out through the nose, because the nose is where prana lies, right? It's where you get your soul's energy. And just really be thankful for the little things today. Whether you live in the shittiest apartment and the worst side of town, be thankful you have a roof over your head. Be thankful that you have running water to take a shower with. Or if you live in a lavish house, like, and you're just tired of paying for it, and tired of doing the yard work, and tired of all the maintenance, be grateful that you even have those worries. Don't make them worries. Make them blessings. Change your perception and everything around you will start to glow. And my talk today is about being more kind and compassionate towards others. For example, I was on Twitter the other day and I saw a fight going on between people who, one was vegan and had posted a very beautiful video of a cow and a pig playing, and someone had to come and troll and put a picture of basically a hamburger with bacon on it and said I had to go there. And they got in this huge fight. But the guy who had posted the picture of the bacon and the burger was kind of just being a little bit more dismissive and funny. And it was really hurting the person who was trying to advocate for the life and soul of the animals. And my advice to her was, save your breath for the wise, because in the end they'll be wiser for it. Try to push your beliefs onto someone or get angry at someone will never, ever, ever solve anything. Our goal as people is to be compassionate and kind to everybody, to every earthling, man and animal. Does that make sense? And our environment, our lovely environment that gives us oxygen, that enlightens us with peace and well-being, basically. And if you are kind to someone, they are more likely to try a different lifestyle. Not trying to change them, but broaden their horizons. So let's say, for example, this guy was very upset with this girl, in a way. Even though he wasn't acting like it, he was trying to be funny. He's still upset. And he might just go eat a bacon cheeseburger out of spite. You know, despite the fact that he thought that the cow and the pig playing were cute. So, without getting mad at someone, try this instead. Try enlightening them and being kind, and maybe perhaps he would try a Beyond Burger or a vegan restaurant or be more open to things. You cannot try to force. Well, that's a big bug. Good morning, bug. You cannot try to force anything on anyone. Just like in a relationship, you can't force someone to stay with you. It's their choice. You can't force someone to do something they don't want to do or they don't understand. So the best thing you can do is just be kind, be compassionate, be understanding, be forgiving, be loving. And do that to yourself as well. Tune in to yourself. Love yourself. Forgive yourself. Be at peace with yourself. And you will then be kind to others. Recognize that suffering happens. It happens. But you cannot allow yourself to suffer because those people are suffering, or because the animals are suffering, or because the earth is suffering, because then your suffering just spreads negative energy around, and that doesn't solve anything. So our goal today is to not put your attention towards things that allow you to suffer. You stub your toe. Who gives a fuck? Let it go. Let it go. Because the minute you stub your toe, you're going to then throw a dish, and the dish is going to break, and you're going to be pissed that you broke a dish. I'm just saying, it's just one thing snowballs into another thing. So why not snowball positive energy? Why not snowball compassion and kindness and giving to people? Everything is a reflection. What you project, you get back. So don't project the negative. And if you are projecting the negative and you can at least be aware that you are, don't be mad at yourself for doing it. Forgive yourself and move on. It happened. You were a bitch. You were a jerk to someone. Let it go. Forgive yourself. Laugh it off. It's okay. Alan Watts says, you don't have to be the same person you were 5 minutes ago. So don't worry. Let it go. Just be. Become aware of when you're being negative. Become aware of when you're upset. Allow it to resonate, and then allow it to pass. And your life will be so much better. Everyone's life around you will be so much better. And that energy, that positive energy, is what can change the world. It's what can move mountains. So, my friends, be at peace today. Say loving things to yourself and to others. Don't focus on the bad. Whatever you give your attention to, it grows. So why not give your attention to something that's beautiful and magical? Blessings.